Today on WCW Pro, the main event will be inside a steel cage. It's Thunder Cage 91. The new six-man tag team champions, the York Foundation, will take on the former champions, Dustin Rhodes, Big Josh, and Z-Man. The cage match on WCW Pro.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to WCW Pro Wrestling. I'm Jim Ross. Thanks very much for being with us, fans. At the top of the broadcast, you saw the footage of the upcoming Thunder Cage 91 match. It'll be in this hour. And this match has taken on a great deal of added significance because last weekend, the York Foundation won the six-man tag team championship over the team they will face in the cage here today. And I'm referring to Dustin Rhodes, Big Josh, and the Z-Man. That first ever cage match here on WCW Pro coming up in the next 60 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following special contest, it's the Thunder Cage Match. Six-man tag team action. Introducing team number one from the North Woods, weighing 275 pounds, Big Josh. Minneapolis, Minnesota, 251 pounds, the Z-Man. And from Austin, Texas, weighing 261 pounds, the Natural, Dustin Rhodes.
This is the main event here on WCW Pro. Thanks for staying with us, everyone. Jim Ross back with you. Let's get down the introductions of the York
and
Foundation.
And wrestling fans, their opponents. They will be led to the ring by the executive director of the York Foundation, Alexandra York. First, from Atlanta, Georgia, Thomas Fritsch. From Nashville, Tennessee, Richard Morton. From Vero Beach, Florida, the computerized man of the 1990s, Terrence Taylor. The World Six-Man Tag Team Champions, the York Foundation.
And the York Foundation, the new six-man tag team champions. They have been the champions only a few days now, and this is a grudge match. It is not a championship event. But the former six-man champions are anxiously awaiting the York Foundation. Rhodes, Big Josh, and the Z-Men are ready. They're in the ring. I don't know what kind of computer program Ms. York has compiled here. But a lot of regular wrestling strategy can be thrown right out the window when you have a cage match. And senior referee Nick Patrick has been assigned this contest. Fans, don't forget that the latest edition of WCW Magazine is on sale now at newsstands around the country. Sting is on the cover. WCW Magazine just gets better and better with every issue, and certainly for all wrestling fans is a must-read each and every month. You can buy it at the newsstands or by subscription. And they are locking the cage. Six-man action. Gordon Nelson, former veteran wrestler, locking the cage. And Ms. Alexandra York is not too enthralled, but they knew the rules when they signed this situation. It's padlocked shut with a heavy chain. And it will stay locked until there is a decision rendered in this contest. A lot of big things we'll be telling you about here next week. And we fully expect ravishing Rick Rude and his new manager, Paul E. Dangerously, to be on this broadcast next week. And it's Big Josh starting out against Richard Morton. One of the oldest and most conclusive types of wrestling matches is the steel cage match. And Morton trying to get the advantage, and Big Josh fighting his way out of the corner of the York Foundation. Tremendous left hands, and Morton get out of here. And Big Josh with a double handful of hair, grabbing Morton just in time as Morton was about to make a hasty retreat. And he knocks him off the top turnbuckle. Morton back in the friendly confines of his own corner. Terrence Taylor has been tagged in. Taylor is somewhat anxious, a little apprehensive. Can't say as I blame him for that. Collar and elbow tie up. Taylor trying to gain the advantage with those right hands. And tried to ram Josh's head into that chain link fence there. But Josh has blocked it. Elbows Taylor to the canvas. And there's a little log roll early in the contest. Bag is made. Here comes the natural Dustin Rhodes. Great right hand. Dustin has his fist heavily taped. They exchange wrist locks, and Dustin catches Taylor with a lariat, hooks the leg, going for it right here in a near fall. Got 2.5 that time. Back to the arm bar. Obviously, Dustin at 6'6 has a decided leverage advantage. Dustin working on the arm. Taylor trying to figure a way out of this one. The veteran from Vero Beach, Florida, now must contend with the Z-Man. The Z-Man takes it a turn. Both men countering each other. Now Z-Man with the advantage, drops the arm across the bicep and bars it up. So Taylor's left arm now being challenged by his opponents. Z-Man really wrenching back on it. And Big Josh having to be restrained by Nick Patrick. Josh in with a thunderous chop. Again, working on the arm of Taylor. And is Taylor making the tag to Big Josh's former fishing buddy, Thomas Rich. And Rich with right hands. Now they've got Josh helpless in that corner. Rich snapmares a Josh out of the corner. Went for the elbow, but Josh moved out of the way. Lucky for him. And now Big Josh with the Irish whip to the center of the ropes. Catches Rich with a clothesline of his own. And now we'll see how Rich reacts to the log roll. Big Josh's compassion for his former friend had a direct bearing on the York Foundation winning the six-man tag team championship. Crowd here really into this match. A very dangerous environment for these athletes to compete in, this steel cage. I've officiated many of these matches, and it's really, oh my, well, that's self-explanatory there. But these guys really put their careers on the line when they get inside a cage. So many injuries occur in here. As you can see, it's just a chain link type fence, all steel attached to the ring. Taylor in, collar and elbow with Big Josh. Big Josh now forced back into the corner by Terrence. And Taylor with a shoulder block there, make it a pair. But a nice reversal by Big Josh, and he went a little bit too over anxious there. And Taylor caught him coming in. Good veteran move by Terrence. And now it will be Taylor climbing the ladder from the outside, going up for a high-risk move here. Taylor going for it all, and he got it.
Got him!
And Big Josh showed great power. I thought Taylor might have had him right there. He got two out of it, a good long two, as a matter of fact. And now Taylor buries a knee into the ribs of Big Josh. Backbreaker. And right there, lateral press. What power. Man, he's got a lot of strength left. Taylor now making the exchange with Richard Morton, or excuse me, with Thomas Rich. And clothesline takes Big Josh down, the knee to the head. And now here comes Richard Morton. Kicking Big Josh right in the head. And a lot of big things going on right now in WCW. Rick Steiner's challenge to Lex Luger for the World's Heavyweight Championship. Rick Rude's challenge to Sting for the U.S. Heavyweight Championship.
Get on down, big boy.
Big Josh now in jeopardy here. And look at this. He's got great strength, I'll tell you. He just will not quit. Look to the midsection. There's a belly-to-belly suplex. Great counter move, and Big Josh makes a very timely tag with Dustin Rhodes. Dustin Rhodes, Bionic Elbow. And each of the York Foundation has tasted that elbow now. Oh, elbow. And this one is a no disqualification situation, obviously. Strength by Dustin. Boy, Rich was really assaulted there. Rhodes and Z-Man certainly have a great deal of animosity, and rightfully so, for the York Foundation. They were very proud to be the six-man tag team champions. And what does she want? Trying to buy the key from Gordon Nelson of our ring crew. And Richard Morton tried. He blocked. Both men blocked it, as a matter of fact. You can see, and quite obviously, common sense will tell you, you're going to try to stay. If you're in this match, you're going to try to do everything you can to keep your body away from the steel fence and from those steel supports. York Foundation making another exchange. They've got three very experienced men in their unit, led by what many people perceive as one of the top two or three tag team wrestlers of all time in Richard Morton. So they are going to be very prolific six-man tag team champions as time progresses, in my opinion. Right now, Terrence Taylor's got the arm barred on Dustin Rhodes. He's got a big... Rhodes has a big leverage advantage, as we mentioned, and Taylor's wrestling a smart match, as he usually does. Matt wrestling Dustin, who's back up to a vertical base, hammers the right hand, Irish whip, and Dustin in, and he was a little bit over-anxious, as Big Josh was earlier in this contest. Dustin now being sternly tested, and look at Rich using the rope. I'm sure you are wondering why the referee hasn't counted them out or in the process of doing so, but this is a no disqualification event. Right hands, a lot of impact, you can hear that. Taylor rakes the eyes. Now where's he going? Both men climbing up to the top rope. And look at Morton climbing down the rope. Here comes Big Josh. They're all going to gather at the river here in the corner. All four men up on the top rope. And Taylor's head rammed into the top of the steel. And Morton faced the steel as well. Big Josh buried that left hand into Taylor. And now they're double-teaming Terrence, who comes down chest first to the canvas. Tag made. Z-Man now, the legal man in. Kick right to the ribs, trying to crack the ribs of Terrence Taylor. And Taylor retaliates by raking the eyes. Z-Man temporarily blinded here. Caught him with a kick. He caught him with a super kick. Lateral press, but Morton interrupts the count. What a dynamic offensive move by the Z-Man. And Taylor drives his head up into the jaw of the Z-Man and tags in Thomas Rich. Neck breaker. Nicely done by Rich. And he drives the elbow to the throat of the Z-Man. Very hard fought match. Another illustration of why WCW is considered by far the hardest hitting professional wrestling action in the world today.
Hey, wait just a second.
You got the York Foundation has got great teamwork. You got to admire that. Hey, there's a sunset flip. He's got him pinned. Referee Nick Patrick was distracted there by Terrence Taylor. And what a move there by Morton with a clothesline. Morton, not known as a high impact wrestler, but he caught Z-Man with a good clothesline right there. And abdominal stretch. He got it. Finally got it. Doesn't have a hooked in all together. Great young fans enjoying the action. There's just nothing like seeing live WCW action. We certainly appreciate you allowing us to come into your home here on TV. And there was there a tagger? I couldn't see from our vantage point if Taylor and Rich made a legal tag. And I know that was not a tag. York Foundation really operating smoothly here. And I'm not so sure that Nick Patrick's going to allow this tag. He did not see it. And again, Alexander York, maybe she's trying to give Gordon Nelson some stock options or something. But he is standing by his guns. That cage door is not supposed to come open until there's a decision rendered. And now you can see the abdominal stretch. He didn't have it locked in. Takes Z-Man back to his corner. The York Foundation has wrestled the balance of this contest in their half of the ring. Crossbody by the Z-Man. And he didn't hook the leg. And didn't quite have it there. What a karate kick. Great move by the Z-Man. Catching Terrence Taylor. But the Z-Man is not near his corner yet. He's trying to fight his way to his corner. Right hand between the legs, makes the tag. Here comes Big Josh in. Now he's a high impact wrestler, no doubt about that. Irish whip takes him in. High elevation. Taylor now in trouble. Big Josh really on fire here. Double axe handle. And Morton's in. Morton ran face first into the steel. Big Josh with a forearm on Thomas Rich. I think Morton has been lacerated. Taylor now with an advantage. Good drop kick by Dustin. Josh falls on top. One, two, three, and they got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the Z-Man, Dustin Rhodes, and Big Josh.
Well, the York Foundation has been defeated in this grudge match, but right now they are really taking their liberties on their opponent. Big Josh rammed into the steel. Morton is bleeding. Big Josh has been cut by that steel fence. His buddy Thomas Rich, what a friend he is, working on him, looking Morton up on the top turnbuckle. This one has really turned into a brutal brawl there. There, Josh has been lacerated. They're finally opening the cage door. What a matchup here. The York Foundation may have lost this match, but perhaps they have won the war. And we'll be back with more. Don't go away right after this timeout.